Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon to you all, our brothers and sisters.
My name is Rashida.
And I'm Omar.
And welcome back to the Bakis
family.
Yes, hope you have a beautiful weekend, a beautiful Saturday.
Yeah.
Is it a good morning, a good evening, wherever you are? Good afternoon.
Today
we are back with our Prophet series. And those who watched our previous videos, we reacted on
Prophet Adam, alayhi salam.
Prophet Adam, alayhi salam. Yeah. We have some prophets who had also reacted on previously.
We're trying to bring in the prophets in order.
We started before not in order, but now we want to do it in order.
Yeah.
So that you
follow.
You can follow.
Mm.
So today we are going to be reacting on a video called
QABIL HABIL and SHEATH alayhi salam.
Alayhi salam.
Yeah.
So let's go straight to the video.
Qabil's nature was very tough and rough. Habil was more humble and lean. And Shaith was a righteous servant of Allah Azza wa Jal.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala amma ba'd.
From Hawa, she fell pregnant 20 times. Each pregnancy with twins, a boy and a girl. So from Adam direct, he had 40 children.
The first child to be born for Adam alayhi salam was a boy by the name of Qabil. In English or in biblical terms, his name is Cain. And straight after him in the same stomach was a sister. So they were twins. Qabil's twin sister was beautiful, whereas Qabil was not very handsome. After him came Habil. In biblical terms, his name is Abel. And he also had a twin sister, but Habil was a little bit more handsome, and his twin sister wasn't as attractive.
And at that time, the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was that the male and female from one pregnancy could not get married to one another. It was haram. So the male from the first pregnancy had to get married to the female of the second pregnancy, and the female of the first pregnancy had to get married to the male of the second pregnancy. Habil had to marry the sister of Qabil, and Qabil had to marry the sister of Habil.
Qabil's nature was very tough and rough. Habil was more humble and lean.
So Qabil had to marry Habil's sister, who was not that beautiful. So he looked at his sister and he was wondering, why should Habil get married to my sister who is so beautiful? And why should I marry his sister who is not that beautiful? Why can't I marry my own sister? So now they had a bit of an issue, and they took this issue to their father, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals unto Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and Adam alayhi salatu wasalam instructs both of them to offer a sacrifice unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And based on whose sacrifice is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that individual can get married to Qabil's sister. So the laws of sadaqah at that time were that they had to take whatever they wanted to give in charity, offer unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they had to go and place it on top of a particular mountain, and a fire would descend and gobble up that charity. This was a sign that the charity was accepted by Allah, maqbool, accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Qabil, Cain, he was a farmer. Habil, Abel, he was a shepherd. So Habil, he brings the best sheep that he had to offer as a sacrifice unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qabil, who was a farmer, he brought the worst of his produce, and he placed that on top of the mountain. Fire came down and it burnt the sacrifice of Habil, of Abel. The sacrifice of Qabil was just left like that. So the sacrifice, the charity of Habil was accepted, and the sacrifice of Qabil was rejected.
So Qabil went up to Habil and he told him, I'm gonna kill you. So Habil was much more righteous than his brother Qabil. He said, if you pull out your hands out to me to kill me, I would not do the same towards you, because I fear Allah. If you want to take the sins, then you take the sins, so you could be from the people of the hellfire, and it's only the actions of the zalimin, the oppressors.
So Qabil, now he starts to plot and plan how to kill his brother Habil. And one day Habil gets late to return home. He had gone to tend to his animals. And Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was now worried. Where is Habil? Where is Habil? And then he instructs Qabil, why don't you go and look for your brother? See whether any harm has befallen him and bring him back home safely. Qabil goes out to look for Habil. And whilst he was going by the area where Habil used to let his animals graze, he finds Habil fast asleep by a tree.
Qabil grabbed a massive rock and came and crushed his brother's head with the rock. And Habil was the first human being to be ever killed on the surface of this earth. The Prophet ﷺ said, from that day to the day of judgment, every innocent life that's been killed, Qabil gets a part of the sayyat. Why? Because he is the first one to start this killing and murder. And Qabil feel guilty. I killed my own brother. I got deceived, brainwashed by the shaitan. I killed my own brother. And he looks at his brother. His brother's dead, bleeding. So what does he do? Leave him like that? So Qabil put Habil on his back and went. He doesn't know what to do. Never heard of someone being killed. Never heard of someone being dead. They don't know what to do with the dead body. Confused what to do with his brother. At that moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in front of Qabil, two crows will come. One crow will kill the other one. And then after that crow will kill the other one, will dig up a hole and bury that crow and cover him with the dust. So Qabil saw that, he knew that's the way to do with his brother. So he dug up a hole and he buried his brother Habil in that hole. And then he became from the guilty ones, but did not repent. And what did Qabil do after that? Qabil, he grabbed his sister and he ran away from Adam. He's too shy to face his father and lived on the flat surface of the land. Qabil was the first human being to live on the flat surface of the land.
Qabil did not go back to his father. Information was known by his other brothers and sisters, and the news came to Hawa first, to their mother. Some narrations say that Iblis himself came to Hawa and he said to Hawa, Qabil killed Habil. And she said, killed? What does kill mean? And Hawa didn't know what death was. She said, what do you mean? What's killing? What's death? Iblis told her, it means that he can no longer eat or talk or walk or drink. Then she started to cry. Adam alayhi salam approached Hawa and he asked her, what's wrong? And she wouldn't answer. She kept on crying. He asked her a second time. She wouldn't answer. She kept on crying. And he asked her a third time. She kept on crying and she wouldn't answer. Finally, Adam alayhi salam, he said, this is what the women among our children, they are more emotional at time of death and they will cry more. So Adam alayhi salam kept silent in relation to the news, but he said to Hawa, this will be the inherited attribute of our daughters.
And then Qabil with his sister start to produce kids, and then the descendants of Qabil started on one side and Adam alayhi salam on the other side, and the corruption started to spread from Qabil and his descendants. And then after the death of Adam, it was his son Shaith.
Shaith is one of the Anbiya who is not mentioned in the Quran. He is a Nabi that we know from Sunnah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed 104 scrolls, 50 of them on Shaith. Sayyidina Shaith received revelation from Allah. He is the son of Adam. Adam gave wasiyah to Shaith to take care of the affairs of mankind.
Shaith means the gift of Allah. When Adam alayhi salam lost Habil, and Adam loved Habil because of his righteousness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced Habil with Shayth. And Shayth was a righteous servant of Allah Azza wa Jal.
This son of Adam was very close to him. He obeyed his instructions. He learned from his father. He actually used to remind his brethren, his brothers and the nephews and so on, and the grand nephews. Whilst Adam alayhi salatu was salam was alive as well, he continued to remind and to remind people of the beginning, because there was nothing else to remind them about at that particular time, besides to worship Allah alone and how shaitan had made a promise and so on.
And from his progeny, from his children, came most of the prophets. And some say all of the prophets ended up in his lineage.
And Shayth started to order with justice and fairness in the mountains, and spreading the good and the righteousness among the people that are living around the mountain. On the other hand, Qabil and his descendants were just spreading corruption and evilness, and they even were killing one another. And even the habits of their father was even increasing among them, killing each other and haram spreading among each other. So you had the people living in the mountain, the people of the good, and the people of evilness living on the flat surface of the land. And Qabil's descendants, their men were not as good looking as their women. And Shayth and his people, their women were not as good looking as their men. And from that door, Shaitan played a big role to make the fitna in between. One of the orders of Shayth among his people, he forbade them to mix with the people of Qabil.
And they followed it, they did not mix, and they were saved to a great degree. After some time, a problem arose. Shaitan went to that side in the form of a handsome man. And when he went there, he asked for a job. Look, I need employment. I need to be employed here. So what happened? They looked at him. They decided, yes, good man, come, let's employ you. Let's give him a job. So he got a job. And as a man, he worked amongst them and he worked very hard. And then he slowly started. What did he start doing? It's important we listen to this. He slowly started making sounds. Sound that people had never heard before. Because there were no sounds that people had heard. That was the beginning of time. And now he created a little drum and he beat it. And everybody would come, "What's that sound?" And they would come around him and watch. Then he got a bit of metal and he started hitting it. And then it created a sound and they came. And then he made a bugle and he started blowing into it. And it created a sound and they came and they were excited. Wow, these people are intelligent. They have advanced much more than us. And so they were so happy. And they got so engrossed in it that they slowly started forgetting the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet, on the other hand, Shayth alayhi salam kept on reminding his people. He kept on speaking with his people and he kept on telling his people what was right and what was wrong and so on. And on this hand, we find that Shaitan is teaching them how to do evil, how to create evil. And after some time, they began to follow him. And when they began to follow him, it created a disaster for them. This is how they introduced the musical instruments into existence. And through that, he would control them. They literally set aside a day, an evening, a Saturday evening. And amazingly, to this day, it lasts. They set aside that evening where he would create these sounds. Everybody would come around and everybody would listen to him. And everybody would literally party until there came a time when some of the youth from Shayth alayhi salatu wasalam were visited by Shaytan. And what did he do to them? Something interesting. He went to them and he created a doubt in their minds. He made them ask a question. He made them question the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why is it that we are not allowed to mix with these cousins of ours, with these relatives of ours? What is the law all about? What is the reasoning? What is so bad about them? Look at this question. So when they started asking this question, it was answered for them that look, Qabil had engaged in a crime right at the beginning. He engaged in a sin at the very beginning. And this is what he did. He engaged in murder and his characteristics were different and so on. And for this reason, They were all on one side, and we are ordered not to mix with them. These youth were dissatisfied with the answer. Nah, doesn't sound too good to us. We're not happy with it. When they were not happy with it, some of them decided, let's just have a peep at what's happening, because we've heard that here things are going on. These people are progressing. Let's go and see. So they came down from the mountains and they went. And from a distance they were watching, and they had seen, and it pulled them. Imagine, they did not intend to engage in evil, but when they saw everybody's partying, and what did they see? They saw very good looking females. And so they went closer. And when they went closer, they were seen. Subhanallah. They were seen. And they were good looking men. So the women began to start displaying their beauty and to start dressing up in order to attract. This was the first time Shaitan taught them this. So when that happened, these young men, they came in and they enjoyed themselves. They had music, they had women, they had so much. They were partying, they were enjoying, and they went away. So as the men came back, they told the other youngsters, hey, you don't know what you're missing out on. You see there, they've got different sounds, and these sounds are amazing. Now look, Shaitan uses sound to control man. Wallahi, if you take a look at what a beat is, what is a beat? You start tapping your fingers. What happened? Who's controlling this finger of yours? Shaitan. What happens to your toe? It starts flicking. What happens to your head? It starts moving. What happens to your waist? It starts shaking. Allahu Akbar. So thereafter, these people came back with a bigger group. And they came back with a larger group. And the group was growing. And every time that party happened, there were people from this side who used to quietly go to that side, and they used to engage in sin. The first sins, music was invented. And what else was invented? Created was adultery. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us.
After Adam alayhi salam, Sheath lived on for a few more decades. Sheath alayhi salam, at his deathbed after him, he entrusted it to his most noble son. His name was Enos, who carried out his mission after him. Then after him, his son Kenan, and then his son Muhallalal took the charge of the mission. Muhallalal is the one whom Persians, they claim to be the king of the seven regions. It says that he was the first to cut trees, build cities and big castles. It says that he built the city of Babylon. He defeated Iblis, they say, and his army, and then scattered them into mountains and valleys and killed a huge number of them, as though there was a war between him and the jinns. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best about this. And they say he had a splendid crown, and his rule lasted for about 40 years after his last father. After him came a son named Jared, who took charge of his mission. And here the Quran, the next man or the son that came after him, the Quran mentions him. His name is Idris alayhi salam.
Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi bihamdihi. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
First of all, these stories of prophets, they are not storytelling like someone just woke up in the morning and started giving, created. Yeah, these stories are from the noble holy Quran, and everything in the Quran is true and is authentic. So what we know in these stories are correct. So, but how do you say
about... I'm so speechless, because some of the things that are happening right now, we didn't know they happened long time ago.
Yeah.
And we don't know how they even started. Yeah. Now I've come to realize how music started, and whatever they're saying here is true, because
yeah,
we've all been there. Like you hear like some sound, you start shaking your head.
Yeah.
SubhanAllah, may Allah forgive us, Ya Rab. Because everything that is being said here, this is what is happening. People party on weekends, evenings.
Because what you, if you engage in music, what next is adultery? Of course, you see beautiful women, now to become in Dalek. You see also beautiful men, you get attracted and you follow.
Beautiful men.
You follow. Yeah, I'm saying if you're a woman, you see a beautiful man. If you're a man, you see a beautiful woman. Something like that. Na'udhu bika min dhalik. We ask Allah to protect us and we ask Allah to guide us most. Because we are living in a world of
temptations.
A lot of temptations, brothers and sisters.
Because no one is perfect, we are also not perfect, but at least it is a very big task for us to try and try to be on the straight path.
We seek protection.
Yes.
Every now and then, if you feel the whispers from shaitan, the bad whispers, you seek protection from Allah. Allah will always protect you.
With that being said, thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Please press the notification bell so that when we upload a new video, you're the first to know. And comment down below what you think about the video.
Yeah.
Thank you for being with the Bakis family. See you in the next one.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.